Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. This is Keithy Broom here live on a Monday night. This is number 43 for us. 43rd live hangout we've had since we started halfway through last year, I guess, to try and bring you information about MyPayingAds and now MyPayingCryptoAds, how the business is running, and try and give members tips and sort of information that'll help them in their business. And tonight, we have UDAY NARA on the program. But as you can see, or perhaps you can't see, because there'll be only two of us, I'll have to change screens. He's not with us at the moment because what he did was message me. Can someone just give me the thumbs up in the chat in the YouTube, just so you can hear me nice and loud and clear in the chat group there in the live chat. Someone just give us a thumb up, or yes, we can hear you, please. Thanks very much. Someone there, that'd be great. Obviously, yeah, good, good. Thank you. Now, UDAY said his words might be about 5 or 10 minutes late. I need to finish something, and that way I'll be totally focused on the hangout. So this is the type of owner we have, folks, that he has something urgent to do that he wants to complete to keep the business running smooth, to help someone out or do some coding or whatever he's doing, then he's going to come on the hangout with me. And I've asked members today to put some questions together in the Facebook group. I put the main group, asked some questions in on my wall, and I've got 10 questions. I've got about 15 or 20 questions. Some of them were doubled up. So I'm going to ask UDAY 10 questions. Now, he does like talking, so before he comes on, he does like talking. So I'm going to try and hurry him up a little bit because he gets so involved with his business because he's actually a mechanical engineer. And I'll give you a little bit of a history. If you're brand new, there'll be people who are brand new to watching this hangout for the first time. So welcome to MyPayingAds. My name's Keithy Broom. I'm in Brisbane, Australia. It's been raining all day. It's absolutely be storming all day. So I've been with the company for over 18 months. The company is 2 years old in 10 days, 10 days time, and the company is 2 years old. So what we're about tonight is, I think he's just arrived. Okay, we'll just test that out. UDAY, good evening. Can you hear me, mate?
Hi.
Fantastic. Can you hear me nice and loud and clear?
Yeah, I'm able to hear. How about you? Are you able to hear me?
Yes, loud and clear, mate. We're live for everybody. We've got a million people watching already. Just a million. Yeah. Many tonight.
Yeah.
So, what I'd like to do tonight, UDAY, it's just you and me. And I put it in the Facebook group, which you've probably seen, because you've got eyes everywhere. I can't believe how many things you're on top of all at the once. Now, women are supposed to be able to do 10 things at once, but it appears that you can do about 20 things at once. Does that be about right, mate? Maybe.
No. Anyone can do it. It is that I have taken the initiative. Challenge to do it, so right. Anyone can.
Okay, and that's a good thing that you've taken the challenge. So what I did in the Facebook group, I asked the members to ask some questions that I could ask you tonight, and I've narrowed it down to 10 questions. So I'll try and give you the 10 questions. Just give a brief answer, because I'd like you to talk about the business. Maybe we do the 10 questions first, and then you can summarize at the end just your personal thoughts and where you are with the business right now in 20th of March 2017. And the main thing is, in next week is we're celebrating the second birthday of your company. And that's a fantastic achievement for you, 2 years in business. And it hasn't been a smooth road, has it? Hasn't been a...
definitely.
But what a hats off to you from everybody who's watching, that you've done a fantastic job. So everybody watching, this is on screen now, is the owner of MyPayingAds and the owner of MyPayingCryptoAds, UDAY NARA. He's based in Singapore. Now, I believe you came there in 2003. Is that right? 2003 when you arrived in Singapore?
Yes.
And you studied and you became a mechanical engineer.
Yeah.
So you're very good at numbers. Is that right? Are you very good with a calculator? Do you have one of those special fractional calculators? Do you have one of those?
Yeah, we need that. Yeah.
You do.
We need that for us. For our study.
Yeah. Okay. Well, I'm just struggling with a regular calculator like one of these. You've got the one with the 20 buttons.
Scientific calculator. So every engineer needs that scientific calculator.
Yeah, signed. That's right. Sign whatever. Yeah. Oh, because I'm an architectural draftsman. I'm an architectural draftsman by profession. So we had those for working out fractions and everything as well. So, ladies and gentlemen, this man is a numbers man. He knows numbers backwards, frontwards, sideways, and he knows where every single cent is in MyPayingAds, MyPayingCryptoAds. So, coming up to the 2-year anniversary, I thought I'd get you one on one. So the members have asked for 10 questions, or I'll pick 10 questions. So a real easy one to start. In cash links, when the advert takes over the whole screen, breaks out of frames, so people can't see that they've earned 0.001 or 0.002 of a cent, what's causing that, the breaking out of frames?
Yeah, basically, I think some of the website, right? The real cause for the frame breaking nature, we do not know why. There are certain settings in the websites that web developers put in wherein they don't load properly in the frames. So that's why they go out of frames. Usually our system detects and stops such kind of links. But certain links we are seeing that they are passing through. And whenever we get some report from the members, so we are disabling those kind of frame breaking cash links.
So if the members the members can actually put a little take note of the number, can they, at the top?
No, basically I think there will be a banner number. You can point to the banner and you will be able to see set a number, or you can see the username of the member who is running that advertisement. So if you if you are reporting back to us through the support tickets, so if you can mention the username of that member, then we can be able to locate that and then can be able to disapprove the same.
Okay.
So we have asked our coding team to see why those are being approved, slipping through the system, being the frame breaking nature. For example, in the traffic exchange, if somebody is adding a website, if it is a frame breaking website, then the system will show that it's a frame breaking website and it won't approve the site. So so for the advertisers, the message is, for some reason, we do not know what is that reason. So the web developers put in some settings such that the websites does not open in the frames. That's what I was told by our coding team. So those websites cannot be advertised on this platform. Suppose if it has a nature such that it has the frame breaking nature, then it cannot be accepted for advertising in MPA and MPCA. So they have to choose some other websites.
Yeah. So it's the actual advertisers from the other side that are actually producing that advert that breaks out of frame on our platform.
Exactly.
So not something we can't really do anything about. It's when the ad comes and gets loaded on our platform.
Exactly. Yeah. So that website, whatever that website that is going out of frames, so there are certain hidden settings made by the web developers. Yeah. I do not know what is that. Even advertisers also does not know much about that sometimes, if he or she is not the owner of that website. Yeah. So if an affiliate is advertising, he also may not be aware of, he or she may not be aware of what is the real reason. But certain websites do have such kind of nature as going out of frames. So basically, the system does not accept such kind of websites.
Okay. All right. Question number two. It feels like 20 questions on a quiz show. But question number two, Uday.
Yeah.
In MyPayingAds, the current maximum withdrawal per day is $200 per day. Have you got any plans in the next small future to increase that?
I think we are at the moment we are not looking at increasing it, especially since we have introduced unlimited withdrawals for the leaders' commissions. So which is a kind of additional opportunity for everyone to be able to withdraw more than $200 per day. So I think in the next 6 months or so, we will not be able to make any changes to this current structure. But we certainly open that opportunity whenever it is possible. Then we will try to increase that limit, maybe in small increments and things like that. No increment for the next 6 months at least. So after that, we will be able to see that.
Yeah. Okay. Great. All right. Fantastic. Very good. Now that just to recap. The leadership commission is when you bring a new person into the business and they put fresh funds from their own pocket into MyPayingAds. There's a 10% referral commission paid into your leader's commission wallet, which is the yellow one. Or if an existing member decides, I'm going to grow my business even further by putting more money from my own pocket into the business, then that's 10%. It's when you repurchase the profit that you generated on MyPayingAds or that you... that goes into the regular commission wallet, which is 5%. So I guess what you're saying to members is, let's get behind the business and promote and bring new members in. And to do that, an additional reward is you can actually take that 10% straight out into your own pocket, the leadership commission. That's right?
Yeah.
Okay, great. All right, fantastic. Now, question number three. Someone's asked, how do we get more advertisers onto the platform? How do we get more advertisers? Now, for me, that's a bit of a strange question, but does that member mean, do we get bigger companies in? Do we get people that want to advertise just purely on the website? Or does it mean, do the existing members start advertising more of their local businesses, their friends who have businesses on there, running adverts in the traffic exchange? What's your thoughts on more advertisers, Uday?
Yeah, I think surely it is related directly to the promotional efforts of the members. So what is to be done is members need to highlight the various advertising products that we have at MPA and MPCA and how good are they. For example, they have to test it, each member have to test it, and then they have to see their results to themselves and then promote it in such a way that, okay, so for the in the last 1 week, I have got this many views to my advertisements. So these many views to my cash links, these many views to my websites, these many views to my banners and things like that. So they can look at the results. For example, if one can look at how many PPC clicks that they have got, how many was the targeted clicks, the purchase clicks, and how many clicks that they have got delivered by MP and MPCA. So that way, what they need to highlight is they need to highlight these facts. So for the in the last 1 year, I have got so many PPC clicks to my banners. So when they show these results, maybe on social media or they can make some splash pages with these results showing that MPA is a good platform. It has given me 100 signups. It has given me 200 signups. It has given me so many clicks, so many web views and things like that. So when they promote these results, then they will be able to attract the advertisers. So that is the way to go. And sometimes they can show the what are the price offers for various advertisement credits and plans and things like that. So for example, we have login ads. Suppose somebody can look at what is the daily login ad, static login ad giving how many views to the advertisers. So what is banner ad, one day static banner ad, how many views that it is delivering. So these are the kind of details that one need to know. And these are the details that they need to include in their advertisements that they are putting outside world. So they have to show these results to the outside world so that they will come forward and then buy those services.
Yeah,
so
that's right.
For example, some kind of focused campaigns one need to run. For example, one need to select one campaign. They have to run through the MPA, like they advertise in Traffic Exchange, they advertise in banner ads, they advertise in PPC banners, they advertise in cash links, and see how many signups they are getting. And based on the results, so they need to go and show these results to the others, saying that I have run this test campaign and these are the results that I have got. So that when others see the results, then they will be able to come forward and do more advertising.
Yeah. Okay.
So apart from this, actually, we are also thinking to run some company focused or company run campaigns. So for example, we show the results to the member, saying that okay, we have run this campaign in the last month and it has given these many signups and things like that. So that there is somebody testing the system continuously.
Yep.
So I also welcome the members to test like that and then show the results to the others, so that people will come forward and use the system. In fact, I was impressed with I think it is from Australian member, Mr. Tom, or so he was showing variety of advertisements that are being shown on MPA Traffic Exchange, and I was very impressed with that one. So that what he was trying to see is he was picking up all different kinds of advertisements that he was seeing. So that may be some splash pages, that may be of some health related products, that may be of some affiliate links of other revenue sharing BTC programs or Traffic Exchange programs or something like that. So he was showing that there is a variety of advertisers coming and advertising in MPCA and MPA. So that is the kind of results that members need to show. They have to test it first, they have to gather the results, and they have to show the results to the world so that advertisers will come in.
Yeah, okay. Well, that member, I believe, is Tony. Now he's in Brisbane, and I've seen his posts as well. And what he's picked up on is what you've always said all along: we're online advertising, and what you want is all the members to become online advertisers.
Exactly.
People have these when they buy an advertising pack of 5, 10, 25, or 50, or all the MPCA packs, 0.01, 0.03, 0.05, or 0.1 of a Bitcoin.
Exactly.
And they receive credits in their back office to use to advertise businesses and services. And that's, I know you've been saying this for 2 years. Unfortunately, you're going to have to keep saying it for a lot longer, Uday, to finally the penny will drop for a lot of members that advertise using your credits. Bring some more members in, advertise any business and service you like. And then when we do our 10 ads a day, we will notice different types of advertisers, which we are. In the last 6 months, I have noticed a lot of different types of people advertising on our platform now.
Exactly.
We're 290,000 members now. So we're going to get up. We're going to hit. I asked someone, the members of the Facebook group if we'd get to 300,000 before we turn two. And I'll give you the figures right now, the live figures, 298,332. I'll just refresh the page because I did this 10 minutes ago. 298,350 members. So we're only about 1,700 off, 1,700 off from hitting 300,000. You've paid out $37.6 million. So we need those members, the 300,000 members. By Christmas, I think we'll be at 500,000 or 600,000 members. Do you think that would be around about right in your estimate, the growth of the business at the moment?
We have about average 900 to 1,000 members per day now, so which will be like average about 30,000 per month. So I think at this rate we can be able to reach that. I think.
Yeah, 600,000. Yeah. All right. So that means more people on the platform, more different types of advertisers, a more variety of advertising on our platform, which will bring all different types of people in. And this is just going to get more and more exciting. Now, there's one big question, which I'm going to leave to the last one, which then you can elaborate on. The next question is withdrawal time, 72 hours. Sometimes it goes a bit longer than 72 hours. Do you want to comment on the withdrawals at the moment? It was out for 7 days, then you brought it all the way back to 72 hours, which is what we say in the details page, between 48 and 72 hours. Is there a, sometimes it goes over by an extra day or so. Is there any reasoning behind that?
I think I mentioned it a few times, basically. So you see, for example, sometimes we are having a downtime to the site, which will slow down our process, basically, withdrawal processing. For example, the other day, I think on Friday night or so, we had about few hours of downtime and things like that. And whenever some downtime happens, what happens is that we need to rigorously test whether the mass pay is working fine or not. Because sometimes the system in a more different manner, such that sometimes mass pay does not work, or sometimes mass pay does not work for selected processors and things like that. So what happens is that it will slow down our process, the withdrawal processing process, and also we have to make sure that the mass payouts are working fine. It is not paying dull, or it is not missing any payments, or it is not showing any error and things like that. And this is one thing that slows down our process sometimes. Then we have to catch up. We have to catch up whatever the withdrawals that we have missed, so that we go beyond 72 hours. And and certain times, what happens? The processor websites does not work as good as what it shall be working. Sometimes they don't respond. Sometimes mass pay, there will be some kind of lag between the processor and the website, such that certain payments will get missed, or certain payments will go double and things like that. So what happens is that in such situations, we have to stop for a while and test it and make sure that the website, the communication between the MPA website and the processor website is correct, and every payout is going smoothly without any error and things like that. And then we resume the process. And if any such kind of error happens over the weekend, usually processor technicians are also not available during weekend, and they only work during the weekdays. And if some error happens during the mass pay or any integration between the MPA website and the processor website, so we have to wait until Monday for them to come back and fix the error, so that we resume the withdrawals again. So these are some daily glitches that we found and we find and things like that. So whenever we have some kind of issues like this, then the withdrawals may slightly get delayed, and as soon as it is being fixed, then we will resume the normal withdrawal processing. That's how it works mostly.
Okay, well, the bottom line is we're dealing with the internet. We're dealing with zeros and ones of codes going back and forth. And all businesses will have ups and downs, as you say, slight errors, and you want to fix those errors, especially when you're dealing with members' money. And we really appreciate the fact that you want to get that right 100%. You don't want to be paying the wrong people. So just delaying for a few hours to make sure that is all correctly done is fantastic. So thank you very much. Now, a quick question. Is there any chance of having, or any option with the script that we've got, of having your ad packs on the home page? At the moment, to work out how many ad packs you've got, you have to go to purchase ad pack, buy ad pack, and then they come up on the third screen. Is there any options to have it on the home page? Is that in the script? Is that a possibility, do you think?
I think we have to check with our coding team. And what I was told is a lot of features like this, they will slow down the site loading, actually. So most of the times, whenever we ask for such kind of features, coders usually try to discourage us sometimes, because there is some kind of optimization going on always. Otherwise, if we have too many places where things need to be updated on every second and things like that, or millisecond and things like that, then the whole site loading will get affected. So I think that is the main reason that whatever we have the settings, these are all well optimized. These are all well thought and well optimized, well tested and things like that. So if we are not able to bring certain features, means I think that is related to the coding difficulty or site loading difficulty and things like that. So I think I will note down, I have noted down this requirement that the members are looking for. And I will take it to the coding team and see if they're able to do. I mean, we are very happy to bring that feature.
Yeah, okay. Well, that's a good answer that in behind your home page, there's so much data going on behind, and you want the site to load as quickly. When your username, password, and I hope everybody's using a two-step authentication with their Google Authenticator app to secure their site so that no one can get into your back office except you via your mobile or your cell phone. Hopefully people are doing that, because you can activate that in your back office. That there's so much activity behind the home screen, you wanted everything loading fast. You don't want things to be loading all the time and slowing it down. So that's a very good point that a lot of people wouldn't be aware of. So thank you, Udo. Right, this is question number 24. This is number 6. My paying crypto ads. We're using Bitcoin at the moment. Now, this is two questions, but the first one is, I know you talked about Ethereum before, months ago.
Yeah.
We're using Bitcoin. Is there plans to bring in Ethereum or any other cryptocurrencies in the 3 to 6 month window?
Yeah, I think we have plans. So I think that was the, I mean, that is the vision behind the MPCA, wherein we want to bring in a variety of the cryptocurrencies as we move along. At the moment, our coders are working on certain other tasks. I think they will certainly need about 2 to 3 months to finish these things. After that, they will work on the Ethereum ad packs. So, so wherein they will buy, members will be able to buy with Ethereum, and they will get the rewards in Ethereum, and they will be able to withdraw in Ethereum. Basically, that is the idea, so that we don't get any fluctuations in terms of price with respect to BTC and things like that. So that is what we are looking at. Certain members were asking whether they can buy BTC ad packs with Ethereum. They're looking at that option. Before we bring in Ethereum ad packs, probably there is a chance that we may accept Ethereum also to buy the BTC ad packs in MPCA. So that is under consideration. We are currently looking at that option. Not sure whether we'll be able to bring it or not, but that is an option. Ethereum ad packs, surely we are going to work. We have to see whether everything will go smoothly or not, because it's a new coding that needs to be done. I think in the next, after 3 months, it will be able to start. The coding work will start after 3 months. And in about next 4 months, we will be able to see some development on that.
Okay, fantastic. Well, okay, members, you heard it straight from Uday. He is planning ahead all the time. As far as running a business 18 hours a day, his brain is ticking over and he's always thinking ahead of how to improve the business, how to grow the business, how to bring different types of people to our business. I hope that answers a lot of people who are thinking, well, what's going on here and what's the plans, which is our main question, which I'll get to in a minute. But just on the back of that, Bitcoin has just dropped in Australia from $1,700 for one Bitcoin went down to $1,380, $1,390. It's back up over $1,400 now, Australian dollars. Now, there's a talk in the media of what they call the Bitcoin hard fork. Is that splitting, doing something with Bitcoin? Now, I saw someone in the Facebook group ask that question and you answered virtually straight away. So could you explain what your thoughts are on Bitcoin and its situation at the moment? It's grown tremendously well in value over the last 6 months and it's just come back down a little bit. What's going on in your opinion with Bitcoin?
No, I think Bitcoin fluctuation is a natural thing. So, I mean, anyone dealing with Bitcoin, they must have realized by now that the value is not fixed, just like any other shares or share market or something like that, because that depends on many other factors, like what is going on in politics, what is going on in government policies, and what goes on. So it's all like there are many factors that will influence the rate of the Bitcoin. When it's coming down, going up, it is a natural thing. I mean, it is not surprising. I mean, people are not asking why it is going up when it is going up.
Yeah, that's right.
Only people are asking when it is going down why it is going down. So you must have you must be worrying when it is going up also. But yeah, we are enjoying when it is going up, and we are worrying when it is going down.
Yeah.
I think one need to realize that it is the nature of the Bitcoin. If you are dealing with it, I mean, that is it, and you have to deal with it. Probably you have to be a bit more smarter in looking at trends, what are going on, and what are the outside situations that are influencing the Bitcoin price. And probably you have to look at when to, suppose if you are trading, you have to look at when to sell it or when to buy it, or these kind of things. I mean, we are also learning. We are not experts, and we are learning, and we are improving ourselves in understanding the facts and things like that. So as per the whatever changes that may come in, so we have to see what will come in, basically. Certain people are saying that it won't affect much, or certain people are saying that it will affect much, and we cannot prejudge the things, and we have to wait and see what changes will come in, and whatever changes that will come in, we will discuss, and we will talk with the experts and take the advice, and then take the course of action, whatever that is needed.
Yeah. Okay, great. Thank you very much. And you're perfectly right. People are so happy when it's going up, and they get worried. But that's some people's human nature. Unfortunately, we can't do anything about that, Uday. But we can work on building our business. Three more questions to go. One's a quick one. We covered this before, but the MyPayingAds debit card. You still got that on the back burner? You're still thinking about that in the future, to have your own debit card, a MyPayingAds or MyPayingCryptoAds debit card?
Yeah, I think it is still a long way to go, I would say. I think the first priority is getting some credit cards on board where the members can be able to purchase. I think that is one of the priority. First, we will work on that so that we will understand how things are working in terms of dealing with credit cards, debit cards, and things like that. Because usually there is a lot of fraud in that, and there are some companies got burnt with using credit cards, actually, because they have their dealings with the banks have got affected because of the fraudulent purchases that a lot of members have done and things like that. So there is always a kind of we need to take extra care in dealing with credit card purchases and things like that. So I think the agenda is like this, that first we will bring in credit card purchases into the system. We are still able to identify a good partner for that purpose, and the next step is working on some kind of debit card. I think it's a long way to go, but I think we will target to achieve it in 2017, surely.
Okay, great. Just on the back of that, for Know Your Customer, KYC. Now, you're going to bring that into MyPayingCryptoAds in the near future. Are you going to do that for MyPayingAds as well, or just MyPayingCryptoAds?
I think we will do it for MyPayingAds also. I think we will surely do it. Whenever we talk with any legal agencies and things like that, they want to see that where from you are getting payments and to whom you are paying payments.
Yeah, right.
And what they told us was, if you do not know to whom you are paying, that's a fraud.
Yeah, right.
So you have to know exactly to whom you are paying.
Yeah.
Because government agencies does not want us to work blindly paying to some unknown person. I mean, it is a fact, we have to deal with it. So I think KYC will come to MPA as well. So we will do it for MPCA and we will do it for MPA. So we will do it in the due course of time.
Yeah, okay. All right. Well,
we don't have any fake members. We don't have any any stacking of the accounts, and we can be able to detect any hacking easily and things like that. So this is all to protect the members, to protect us, to protect our funds and things like that.
Yeah, okay. So just for a recap for people who don't know what KYC means, it's know your customer. It's a security terminology that a lot of agencies and processes use, that you've got to prove that you're a real human, either by standing in front of a taking a photo of yourself with a driver's license, a selfie photo, or a piece of paper with your name on it and you're there, and as well as uploading a document with your address on it, which is valid in the last 3 months. A lot of the processes now, you have to do that before you can even get your account verified. So that's what we're going to be bringing in to MyPayingCryptoAds and into MyPayingAds. And for those very reasons, Udo's just said, there'll be no fake profiles. It'll be really easy to identify hackers. Anyone who's trying to get into our company, and we say this as a family chat, Udo's protecting the whole family, all 300,000 of us, from the nasties that are trying to get involved. Because we're a successful company, people want to bring us down or get involved to take our money. And that's part of KYC, know your customer. So just be ready for that when it comes in the near future. Thank you, Udo. Two to go, mate. Two questions to go. One is about changing your sponsor. Now, we see this a lot in the Facebook group, that people have signed up, whether they've realized who they're signing up under or not. They've seen an advert somewhere on the internet. They said, I've heard about this company. I'll join with this person. They joined under so-and-so. Sometimes they join under admin, which is you, not realizing that that's the company sign up. Or they join under someone, John Smith member, whatever it perhaps is, and they try and email them for help and they try and contact them for help and they don't get any help at all. And they come to the Facebook group or come to other people's videos for help. Is there any option to change a sponsor when you're not getting the help you require, maybe a one-time off, or is it not really in the company's interest to do that? What's your thoughts on that?
I think I mean, the strict policy that we are following is not to change the sponsors, because that's going to mess up the things so much. And we go case by case. We go case by case. So surely, first, what we want the members to do is members communicate with the sponsor before they. Excuse me. Before they make any purchases, I think that's what we want the members to do. So they have to see that they got the right sponsor. I mean, some people, they are fine with anyone, so they don't wait for anything and they just make the purchase and they will go ahead and things like that. So, but if you are very specific of having certain sponsors, so the members have to make the check properly, and only after make sure that they got the right sponsor, they shall be making the purchases. I think that's what we want the members to do. And we are very strict in terms of not changing the sponsors. I mean, it is sometimes difficult, and it sometimes may disappoint you. But what we have to make sure that the member has brought in you. I mean, so he has done his job, and you have to be under him. I mean, for example, if I'm promoting a company, I go and buy some advertising, paid advertising in another company, and advertise. And if someone comes, it is unfortunate that they are not mentoring as the way that they need to do that. But we also need to look at the situation that. He has brought in you to the company, so we have to give the due respect to that sponsor as well. And probably what we will do is, I think we have not done it previously, but just now some thoughts coming to me is I think we will also communicate with the sponsor and ask him to go back to his referral and try to be in touch with him, try to do the mentoring and things like that. And probably we will do that. So that and if he is still not being responsible or something like that, probably we will make some changes to the sponsor or something like that. So I think we want every sponsor to be responsible and things like that. And sometimes the member, for example, my sponsor is not working, or when I go to my sponsor, he is trying to take me to another company and things like that. So these are some special cases where we will investigate, and if there is some kind of activity like that, we will consider to change the sponsor. But otherwise, sponsors are not changeable, and once the member joins, make sure that whether you have went to the right sponsor or not, and before making the purchases, or if there is any error, you can always contact us so that we will make the correction and things like that.
Okay. Well, there's obviously some responsibility when you're signing up under somebody into our business that you're prompted to make sure that this is the correct sponsor. You've made that decision yourself, and like you say, before you buy any ad packs, communicate with a sponsor and say, I've just joined your team. What plans do you have? Do you have meetings? Do you have hangouts? How do you normally help new people? I'm new to this industry. And that's the thing. With 300,000 members now, they're all, a lot of people, a couple of 100,000 people are brand new to online marketing. Now, I went to a meeting today with one of our ladies in Brisbane. She's not actually in my team, but I went along to help her talk to a new person. Never heard about our style of business, online advertising profit share. Not quite sure how it worked. Had her own other online business. Wanted to get involved in something like this to make a part-time passive income on the internet.
Yeah.
Every person I speak to, Uday, wants to do that. Online passive part-time income. Yeah. Because they all have a job during the day, but they want to make additional money for their family. And that's your goal, to pay everybody who's part of our program, and I know that, and you're doing that fantastically. Yeah. $37 million nearly. So people, when they join our business, it's online advertising. You have to learn about our business, and the way you do that, when you log into your account, at the top is the Facebook logo, join there, and the file section that Birgit has done up with all the files and Anarchy, there's about 70 separate files there, so there's no shortage of information. We have our own YouTube channels and an icon there as well. There's no shortage of learning, and I know we're going to introduce some training on the actual website itself at some stage. That's another thing. So we will help as much as possible, but as an individual, as a human being, as a person with two eyes, two ears, two arms and two legs, for the most of us, you have to take responsibility for yourself. You can't, I always do this, Uday, don't point the finger of blame at someone. My sponsor.
Yeah.
If you turn your hand over, there's three fingers pointing back at the real problem. Now, that's me. What can I do? What can I learn? What can I do different? What can I step back and think, well, that's not working, I'll go around that and carry on. So, all right, we'll get to the last question, mate. Next week, we're all going to, I'll see you physically for the first time next week. It's going to be fantastic. There'll be lots of photos, lots of interviews, lots of hangouts, lots of live Facebook chats. It'll be great. But the main question that everybody's been typing furiously here on the live chat, and all the questions that I've received in the Facebook group today, is this: where will MyPayingAds and MyPayingCryptoAds be in 2, 3, 5 years from now, in your opinion? And what can you say about the business you've created? You've been through the PayPal issue with a company much, much bigger than us, a massive worldwide company that tried to put conditions on you. You've fought against that, returned all the money to the members after 180 days, got through that, got through issues with server. We've grown, our numbers have doubled in the last 12 months. They'll double again more in the next 9 to 10 months. So as we're growing, we've got more and more staff. We've got about 10 staff at the moment, have we, in support and everything else.
Yeah.
What's your thoughts on where we'll be in 2 to 5 years to all the members? Obviously, people join a business like us, they're so excited, they get addicted, they check their mobile or cell phone 3 times a day to see if they can buy another ad pack. because they're earning, they're running ads and they're getting feedback and getting some people joining other businesses. What's your thoughts of these people who join MPA, love MPA and MPCA, and want it to be here for a long, long time? What's your thoughts on where we're going to be 2 to 5 years? What's your strategy is what people, I guess, want to hear from the owner of the company.
Yeah, so I mean, sometimes predicting for 5 years may be difficult because it's a very fast changing world. This online advertising also, there is always a lot of changes, a lot of new companies comes, a lot of failures and a few successes and things like that. So I think what we need to go, our vision always is to run it smoothly and steadily for long term. I think these are the keywords that we always keep in our view to move forward and to make any changes or to make any plans and things like that. So having a steady sustenance for the company. So as I always have been telling, so for example, if we are giving a prediction or if we are giving a expectation of ad packs being matured or expired in about 60 days, so that's what we want to deliver for a long term. So deliver what you are giving an expectation to the members for long term. I think that is our goal. That is our grand goal. So, and as well as to serve more advertisers. So, what we need to do is becoming more popular as a lead generation program. So, we want to see that lot of other programs are getting benefit from MPA and MPCA by getting more signups, by getting more sales and things like that. So, these are the things that we need to take care. So one is running the company in a more steady manner. So without getting worried of whether we are getting enough sales or not. So to make sure that enough sales are coming so that we are able to honor the withdrawals without any difficulty and maintain the same kind of earnings that we have been providing to the members. And without missing any payment and things like that. So we want to make sure that we run this company in a more steady manner without any fluctuations in that aspect. Not missing payments, not having fluctuations to the earnings and things like that. So that is one aspect. And the second aspect is we want to see that we have more surfers, more high quality surfers and advertisers on the platform. I think I mentioned this in one of the Hangouts because whenever advertisers comes, they want to see that they are getting signups and sales. So that only will happen when we have the high quality surfers and advertisers on platform. So and advertisers also needs variety of members viewing the advertisements, like from every country, from every continent and from every culture and things like that, so that whatever product that they are selling, they will get the sales of those products. I think that is one of objective that we are moving forward to achieve that. And and apart from this, what we want to do is we want to bring in a few more payment processors to the system so that it will be easier for the members to make purchases as well as to withdraw the earnings, as well as to cover more different countries where only certain payment processors are working better than the others and things like that. So definitely we will try to achieve that in 2017 of bringing few more payment processors.
All right, in MPA. Right.
First thing is in MPA, few more payment processors, and in MPCA, few more altcoins. People can be able to buy with other coins and other ad packs like Ethereum ad packs and things like that. So those are the ones that will come. And the second thing is we want to reach out to the large audience. So then only there will be more sales that we can generate to the advertisers. So for example, at the moment we are growing at the rate of 1,000 registrations per day new signups. So new members are joining. So we want to have that in a consistent manner. So we want to have that continuously and in increasing numbers, so that we can have more surfers and more advertisers on board, so that we can be the one of the top quality advertising platforms.
Right.
So advertising platform will only survive if we deliver the results. If we don't deliver the results, the advertising platform will not survive.
Yeah.
So that is what we have to achieve.
Achieve, yeah.
So I think that is what we are progressing, and that is what the vision that we have for the coming years. And how we achieve it, especially in terms of reaching to the more audience, I think in 2017, we will have more seminars and programs coming up in each country, presentations and things like that, seminars and presentations, business meetings and things like that, so that we can be able to reach out to the larger audience. So we can introduce the internet marketing to the people, and we can bring in them on board, so that we can generate more results to the advertisers.
Yeah,
I think new payment processes and seminars that we are going to have in 2017, and study growth. That is what our vision.
Yeah.
For the next 1 to 2 years.
Okay, that's a fantastic answer, Uday. Everybody knows a conservative owner. You're just very, you're steady with what you're, might be a bit of echo here. You seeing a bit of echo? No, that's all right.
No, I think it's fine, yeah.
Yeah, okay. Your approach to me is conservative. As the owner of an online marketing business advertising platform, that is the best way to go. You are very concise in any changes you do. You're slow and steady and concise. And now the growth since I've been involved for 18 months has been slow and steady. There's been challenges to test you as a person, which you've overcome, but you've just outlined your plan for 2017 seminars, and I want to get involved in Australia and run those in the major cities in Australia. There's plans already in place for that for Australia. I know next week that'll be one of the topics I'll be talking to you about, and you'll be talking to many leaders from around the world about their countries and how they can get involved with our company PowerPoint presentation.
Yes.
This is exciting. This is exciting. Like you say, grassroots people going to meetings, talking about MyPayingAds, MyPayingCryptoAds in their local center, in their local city or the local town,
exactly,
run by someone who's following the company presentation. That's exciting. And that's where you get your growth from, people on the ground promoting the business. And you're right, the quality of advertisers will sustain our business. So we want different types of advertisers coming onto our platform and introducing different products to us as advertisers as well.
Yeah.
And then they'll get their sales or they get their views and they'll enjoy our platform. And what they will do is tell other people.
Yeah.
And that's how we've exploded our growth in the last 12 months. People have joined and then told other people, have joined and told other people, have joined and told other people. So 1,000 people a day joining is absolutely fantastic, mate. So thank you very much for those questions. We covered a lot today. We've had a lot of people on the live chat watching live. There'll be thousands watch this over the next week or so. I can just ask everyone watching this to share it on your wall. Share it on your wall as an advertising promotion of the business you're in. The owner has spoken about his long-term, 2 to 3 years. You're right, you can't predict what's going to happen in 5 years. Sometimes you can't predict what's going to happen next week, but you've got to have that determination, the plans in place steadily for steady growth, and this is what you have as a leader. And I can say this from being involved in other companies, I've never seen anyone like you be so acceptable to coming on and being in front of your members 2-3 times a month, so people can understand and hear you of what your plans are for this company. You only want the best for members. I know that, and everyone feels that. So thank you very much for your questions tonight. I'll see you in about 8 days' time. There'll be lots more interviews, live Facebook lives with you and everything like that. I've already ordered your vegetarian meal for the Friday night, the week on Friday. So we all know you're a vegetarian. You're all very healthy, and you've got, you know, you're all sort of, you're looking pretty fit today, mate. You're looking pretty, pretty fit. You've got your sleep and everything's going well. So coming out of next week also, there'll be a lot more information that I'll be able to pass on to members via our live Monday night hangouts that'll be vital for people to understand more growth in this company. So thank you very much, Uday, for tonight. It's been absolutely fantastic. All the members, thank you indeed. And we'll see you, Uday, next week for the second birthday party. Looking forward to that. Good night to you, mate. And good, yes, absolutely. Good night to you, mate, and good night to all the members. Bye. Okay. See you later. Okay, bye-bye.